Looking for some advice on increasing your salary as a software engineer from someone who has been both an employer and an employee? In this video, I'll share 8 tips that I've observed have worked well for me and others. Let's get started. What's up, people? I'm Shobhit, and today we'll explore how to make more money as a software developer or an engineer or a programmer or whatever you call yourself. Before we move forward, I have one request. Please don't hit that like button or subscribe. Please don't do that. Number one, creating tech content for personal branding. You know which is the most favorable trait for you? The one where other party wants it more than you. So in our case, we want companies reaching out to you instead of you applying for specific jobs. To achieve that, you really need a personal brand. Get active on Twitter, start writing blogs, start giving talks, even contribute to open source. But the problem that I see with a lot of people is that they don't do it consistently. They write one blog post in once in a blue moon and then forget about it for 6 months. They start working on an open source library and then abandon it after a couple of commits. To create a good personal brand, you need to do this consistently. Think of the people you really, really want to work with. They have been doing this consistently for a long period of time. People like DHH, TJ Holowaychuk, Jake Wharton, Jeff Atwood. These people have been creating things consistently before reaching any level of success, after which they're in huge demand. But you don't really need to be at that scale to actually be in demand. You can start very small, but do things consistently to make your personal brand better. What if you're not creative enough to come up with, let's say, ideas for blog posts and things like that? Well, in that case, copy others. Put out a take on what others have done, what others have written. Respond to it, react to it. Document yourself. Write down your thought process on why you did exactly that. Why did you take a specific decision? Why did you make a trade-off? Even why did you choose a name for a variable? Actually, a good example of this was when DHH was hunting for a specific name for a good variable name, and he wrote down his entire thought process. I'll link to that article in the description below. Number two, networking. People like to work with people they know, but you're an introverted engineer. You must be thinking, how do I start networking? Do I have to go to events, talk to people, shake hands, even during the coronavirus? What if they don't respond? What if I'm invading their personal privacy, personal space? Look, I get it. It's not easy to talk to random strangers in real life. But you know what? It's super simple online. Make it a habit to send an email to one new person every week. Actually, I would suggest you do it every day so that you have multiple conversations going on at the same time. Sign up for things like Lunch Club. Respond to people you admire on Twitter. Even get close to HRs on LinkedIn. So when you're starting out with networking, everything's fair game. Acquaint yourself with as many people as possible. The great thing about networking is that when a new opportunity, a good opportunity comes along, you'll be the first person to hear about it. I would actually go on to suggest that 95% of the money that I've made has been because of networking. So go network and not the other network. Actually, the other networking is also good. You should try that, Mr. Self.developer. Number three, and this is going to be a controversial one. Move to a city with a higher developer salary. Yeah, I know, it's a bit controversial, but if you're not in a city with high dev salary, move to one which does. In US, it would mean moving to Silicon Valley. In India, it would mean going to Bangalore. When I was in Jaipur, 4 to 5 lakhs was a good salary for a developer. But in Bangalore, we start the conversation at 12 lakhs. That's nearly 2 times the difference. Sure, cost of living is higher, but you will end up saving more in absolute terms. Number four. Get comfortable with negotiations. This is such a simple thing which majority of you guys don't do. There's been so many instances where I offered a salary to someone and they just accepted it. No counter offer. There are many, many, many resources out there which provide specifics as to how to negotiate better. Go through them, practice them. If you could just bear those 5 to 10 minutes of awkward conversation, you could probably get a raise of 5 to 20% at the very least. It's worth it. Number five. Launch side projects. People with side projects, which are live by the way, are in a much better position to ask for more money. They have demonstrable credibility. They have showcased that they are motivated. They can handle things end to end. The employer looks at these people and values them much, much higher than someone who has not done anything apart from, you know, their day job. Side projects also help you understand the whole picture much, much better. You will get your hands dirty with marketing, finance, and possibly the business side of things. These, at the end of the day, help you become a better contributor to your job. Use your side projects as a leverage during negotiations. They'll be very effective. And some of the side projects may directly end up increasing your income, but that's a topic for another day. Number 6, skill up. The birds, they're here. So this is kind of an obvious one. If you are demonstrably better than others, you're paid more. But it's not easy to demonstrate that. So my suggestion is to skill up through multiple other related skills. So if you're a backend developer, learn DevOps or front-end engineering so you can be a full-stack developer. You're a front-end engineer, learn how to design or possibly back-end engineering so you can also be a full-stack developer. You can actually try learning about other fields as well. Marketing, business, product thinking, sales. Having the understanding and a little experience in these related fields gives you a much better perspective, which everyone values. And obviously, you can then use it as a leverage for negotiation and whatnot. You know, I once had an interesting engagement with a client who went with me even though I bid more, because I knew how to play music. I understood music theory, and the project was related to music itself. I was expensive, but I had a better understanding of the project because of other unrelated skills that I acquired. And obviously it helped during the development, and the product was much better because of that. Number 7, be shameless about money. You know, you're too worried about looking like you care for money, and employers out there are actively trying to exploit this fact. Don't worry about what your potential employer might think of you if you talk about money. They are a business and looking for services at a cheaper rate. You should act similarly and value yourself appropriately. Do your research. Talk to people about money. Figure out what your market rate is. What's the highest and what's the lowest for your role? Ask your friends their salaries. All these data points will ultimately help you value yourself better. Number 8. Take risks. Now, this might not be applicable to everyone, especially to people who are further along their career, or a lot of you might not be in the position to do this, but taking risks helps. But they are risks. Quitting your job to freelance could help you earn better, but there's a small chance that you might not make money for a long period of time. Actually, it's not a small chance, there's a good chance. You will obviously need to work on other things as well, like sales, negotiation, but it's doable. Joining a startup as an early employee is also risky, but if it works out well, you will never need to worry about personal branding or how to value yourself correctly. There's a big risk here though, that if that startup fails, it's just another line of experience on your resume which the employer can't verify. And I've seen a couple of people who tried freelancing, but they didn't earn money at all. So your mileage may vary, but it's not a bad idea. Try freelancing. So you should understand what the risks are and how you can manage it better. So these were my tips, and there are multiple other ways to actually go about increasing your salary, but these are probably the ones which anyone can apply. So there you go. Please do let me know in the comments if you've done something before which has worked well for you. Share your wisdom, you know. And remember, you're not supposed to like the video or subscribe to my channel. No, don't do it. Don't do it. Please do it. And again, I'm sorry about the birds and everything. Hope to see you again next week. Bye bye.